In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a photo slideshow using Apple's Keynote app. Whether it's for a birthday, a wedding, or you just want to have a fun way to share memories, Keynote makes it super easy. Let's get started. Keynote is Apple's free presentation software, but it's not just for seminars and business meetings. It's also an amazing tool for creating photo presentations with smooth animations, stylish effects, and even music. First, open Keynote and click New Presentation. Choose an aspect ratio, either wide or standard. You can also select the theme if you like, but for a custom slideshow, I recommend starting with a blank template. I'll choose the basic black one. Before adding photos, be sure you have the right aspect ratio selected. If you're making a video for YouTube or for something that will be displayed on a widescreen device or a television, go with wide 16:9. For social media, phone, or older televisions, square or vertical formats work best. If you change your mind, click Document, Change Theme. Then, across on the right, click the aspect ratio and select Wide or Standard. If necessary, pick a new theme and click Choose. You can add photos to your presentation in a few ways. One, you can insert them directly from the Photos app by inserting a slide and clicking Media to insert an image onto it. Two, you can open the Photos app and drag one or more photos into the Keynote Navigator sidebar, which will add each photo as a new slide. Three, if you want more control over the quality of the photos you're adding, export them from the Photos app to a folder first before you drag them into your presentation. Here's how to export photos. Select the photos or albums you want to focus on. By the way, if you do select a collection of photos, you can choose to add that selection to a new or existing album. After you've made your selection, click File, Export, Photos, or press Shift-Command-E. In the dialog box that appears, select the image format, quality, and other export options you want, and then choose Export. Choose where you want the exported photos to be saved. I'll choose the desktop and then click New Folder and name it. Finally, I'll click Export. Now that we've exported the photos, let's talk about the fourth way that you can insert them into your Keynote presentation, by dragging them from a folder on your computer. Open the Finder, browse to the location where your photos are, and just drag them into Keynote. My photos are on my desktop in a folder called My Export. Notice that when you drag items into Keynote, you can insert the photos at the same level of the existing slides or slightly indented to the right. This won't affect how your presentation plays back, but the indentations do allow you to group images together, which can be helpful in organizing lengthy slideshows or presentations. However, you might find them a little bit confusing. You can drag any indented slides a bit farther to the left to put them in line with the other slides in your presentation. At this point, you might be noticing that each slide has boxes for title and text. However, since we're creating a photo slideshow, we don't need them. Select all of the slides. I'll click one of the slides of the navigator and then press Command-A to select them all. Now, click Format, Slide Layout, Blank. That removes all the text placeholders and lets your photos take center stage. Let's add some transitions. Select all the slides, click Animate, then in the Transition section, click Add an Effect. Choose a transition like Dissolve for a simple fade, Push for a sliding effect, or Cube for something a bit more dynamic. Of course, there are many others you can choose. Try them out and see which ones you like best. You can set a duration that defines how long the transition takes to animate. Some transitions will also allow you to choose a direction. And finally, we can change what triggers a transition. It defaults to on-click, but we can change it to automatically. Last, we can set a delay, which I'll put at 5 seconds. We just applied the same effect to the whole presentation, but you can choose different transitions for each slide if you want. At this point, the slides will advance automatically after 5 seconds each and use the transition effects we chose. You can see that our photos aren't filling up the entire slide because they don't have the same aspect ratio as the presentation. I find it helpful to zoom out of the slide a bit to better see how my image will appear on it. To change the zoom, click this zoom control and choose a smaller number. Alternatively, you can pinch your fingers together or spread them apart on the trackpad to zoom out and in. Click a photo and grab its resize handles to make it bigger or smaller. Let's drag one and make it fill the entire width of the slide. Then we can drag the image up or down to adjust which part of our image will show on the slide. If you want more than one image on a slide, you can cut a photo from one slide and paste it onto another, and then you can resize and position both of them to fit. For some additional polish, you can add effects to your images. Click an image to select it, then click Format. From here, you can select an image style, reflections, and more. I like the picture frame style. You can click on the frame icon to see other picture frame looks. In addition to slide transitions that take you from one slide to the next, you can also add animation to elements on a slide. For example, on a slide with a single image, you can select a photo, click Animate Action, and then click Add an Effect, and choose an effect like Move. When we choose it, we see a red line that shows both the starting and ending positions of the move. Let's take this ending square and drag it around a bit. Then we'll place it where we want the image to end up. In the Action sidebar, let's click Add Action and select Scale. The scale will increase the image to 150% size. Click Build Order to see the list of animation effects on the slide, their order, and how they'll be triggered. Here you can see that the first item is Move, which happens on click. Let's change it to After Transition so that it moves immediately after the slide is displayed. Let's click on the second item, Scale, and set it to happen with Build 1. If we click Build 1, we can see it's set to last just 1 second. Let's change it to 5 seconds. And now let's click on Build 2 and also set it to 5 seconds. When we click Preview, we'll see both the move and the scale happen at the same time. This is like the Ken Burns effect in the Photos app. If we have a slide with more than one photo, we can add animation effects to them all and control the order in which they appear and animate. Click the first photo, then click Animate, Build In, click Add an Effect, then click something like Dissolve. Set the duration, direction, and travel distance. I'll pick 1 second. Repeat the same process for other images on this slide. And then click Build Order and set the order in which the images appear and whether the effects happen automatically or on click. While you can add text captions to your images as part of formatting the image style, you'll find greater flexibility by clicking the text button on the slide, format and position the caption the way you want, and then you can copy and paste the text caption to carry its formatting forward, or you can update the text caption style by clicking it and then clicking Format. Drop me a comment if you want me to make a video about styles in Keynote. Just like you saw with these photos, you can also add animation to text. Right now, our presentation is silent. It's a silent movie. However, adding the right music can create a mood for your slideshow. Click Document Audio. You can add music to your presentation in a couple of ways. First, you can drag any music files from your Mac into this soundtrack box and drag them up or down to set the order of the tracks. Or you might be able to open the music app and drag a song over. However, I think it's easier to click the plus button here in Keynote below the soundtrack box. And when you click this button, you might be prompted to allow Keynote to access your music in the music app. You can add any music you've purchased or any that you've manually added or matched in the music app. However, the songs you add must be downloaded to your Mac before you'll be able to find them here. Songs downloaded from the Apple Music streaming service won't be available to add and won't appear when you search for them. Now that we've added some songs, let's decide whether we want the audio off, each song to play once, or loop. Click the menu across from Soundtrack and choose. If you plan to run your presentation inside the Keynote app, you can make it self-playing and even set it to loop when it gets to the end. Click Document, Document. Let's look at the options. 1, automatically play upon open. 2, loop slideshow until you press escape. Let's check this option. For presentation type, select self-playing. Below that option, set a slide delay time for transitions from one slide to the next. Then set a build time to control how long between each animation on a slide. If you've already set transition durations, your manual adjustments will supersede what you specify at a document level. If you plan to run your presentation outside of Keynote, you'll need to export it as a movie file. After you do that, you can send it or share it with others. Just remember that if you're using commercial music in your presentation, you aren't entitled to upload it to a public website or to YouTube. I should mention that even if you specified that the presentation should loop, your exported movie will only play your presentation one time through from beginning to end and then stop, even in the middle of a song. You can use a video player app like VLC and set it to automatically loop your video once it's played all the way through. With Keynote selected, in the menu, click File, Export to, Movie. Select your options. Notice that our document values have come over. It's self-playing with the transition delay and builds delay below. You can tweak those now. Next is resolution. It defaults to 1080p, which is 1920 by 1080 pixels. However, you can go to custom and enter your own dimensions. Entering larger numbers means a larger file size for your presentation and the resulting video. 1080p is probably sufficient for most of you, but you can try for 4K, which is 3840 by 2160, to see if the file isn't too big. For those who know, the file size will be pretty huge. You can also choose a frame rate and a video format. I tend to leave these as they are, but if you know what they mean, you can change them. Actually, you can change them even if you don't know what they mean, but I don't recommend that. Click Save, then choose what you'd like to name it and where you'd like to save it. I'll pick the desktop and name it My Slideshow. Click Export. Now let's go look on the desktop for our slideshow. Can you add videos to your slide presentation? Yes, you can. Just remember to click Animate, Build In, Build Order, and set the video to play automatically after the slide transition. And if you want the whole video to play, you'll want to avoid using the self-playing document settings I described earlier and set the duration for each slide individually. Alternatively, you can click Play in the menu and choose Rehearse Slideshow to run the slideshow manually and advance it at the pace you like. When you do this, Keynote will remember how long to show each slide and at what rate it should advance any animations on slides that have them. With your timing set or your rehearsal done, you're ready to export your slideshow, although you can choose to keep the whole presentation in Keynote. And that's it. We've just created a slideshow in Keynote. If you found this helpful, hit the like button, drop a comment, and let me know what type of slideshow you're making, or leave a tech question. If you want to see how to create a slideshow using the Photos app on your Mac, check out this video next. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.